Wheelie! Finally, after being in the deep freeze for over a month, the temperature's finally warmed up some and we are going to be putting on an addition to the beast today. What will that be, you ask? Well, for those of you that follow us on Facebook, you'd already know this, but we're going to be installing a new Kimpex Click and Go 2 plow. This one here is actually the plastic model, so it doesn't rust and snow doesn't stick to it as much, and lighter. Maybe I can flip it over here for you. We have already gotten a start on the install. Been working on it inside on the on the dining room table. Because the beast is on tracks, we had to get a frame extension for it so you could still angle the plow without it hitting the tracks when you're plowing. So that's the one there that comes with it for when you have tires on. And you have to switch it out for this longer one. It takes a little bit of doing though, because you gotta remove all the hardware off this here, well, off that one, and then transfer it over to this one. But it's not hard, it just takes a little time. So basically how this works is you will hang your winch cable down through there to there, lift it up about 8 inches, then you'll grab the snow plow, which we don't have on there just yet, and just give it a push backwards, and then those hooks will go into the mounting plate at the back. And then when you want to take it off, you just step on these pedals and off it comes. Also has the quick adjustment for your angle. You step on these and that moves the lock there, and then you can easily turn your blade from the side. Now, because it's going to be pretty tight laying on the ground there, it's probably hard to get the camera up in there, so I just assembled this to show you how it's going to work. You actually have to drill 1/2-inch diameter hole through your skid plate by your foot pegs on the one side. They give you the drill and everything, and it's got a stopper on it so you don't drill through anything. And that will be for this back bolt. So these two bolts will go through by the foot pegs and bolt on the back, and then I got it all together here just to show you, but then these front ones will go up around the frame and this plate will hold them up. This is on the 2012 and newer Can-Am Outlanders. The older ones use a slightly different method, but I'm pretty sure it's the same plates. So yeah, first of all, we're going to get this mounted and then we'll see how that looks. Oh, before we continue on with that, I just have to mention this. We also got the 10-foot replacement synthetic winch line, because snow plowing tends to be pretty hard on your regular winch line and you don't want to wear it all out. I'm hoping I can maybe hook it onto the end of my other one though, so I don't have to unspool it, but we'll see how that works out. And then a new roller fair lead with a nice big fat roller on the bottom here so it doesn't wear so much. Here's the back look of that blade. It's got your little shoes on the end. You can adjust for your height. And the cutting edge was separate. You had to bolt that on. Well, it come with it, but I mean, you had to install that. No big deal. We do actually have the drift cutters for it, but we ordered the wrong ones, so we won't be putting those on right yet. There's that hole I had to drill that's on the left-hand side of the four-wheeler. That's the floorboard support right there. So actually that hole in the plastic, I had to elongate it a bit just so that these plates would sit straight, but pretty tight under here, but that's basically how it looks. I don't know if you can see anything there, but tighten up all the bolts, should be good to go. So that ended up going better than I thought it would, so that's all right. That one plate goes across there and then bolts come up there. So if you ever did want to take it off in the summer, there'd be just four bolts, that one over there, one on the other side, and two at the back. But it's pretty low profile, so it's kind of out of the way. See how it goes. There's another look at it from the front. Those hooks are just going to go there and there. Not too bad at all. Okay, so we got the plow frame mounted to the blade. Just had to attach the two eyelet bolts there and there, and then hook the springs on the top of the blade here. And then one thing to note, if you're putting on plastic blade instead of the steel one, they do give you longer bolts here because the steel ones are too short and they won't work, and don't ask me how I know that, but they do give you the right ones. Here's another look underneath here, how this works. That's for your angling there. So here we are back again. It's the next day. We finished yesterday, but then it was getting dark, so, but yeah, it looks pretty good. Got her all on there, and we finished up with the roller fair lead, just the two bolts on there. I haven't put the other winch line on yet. Might try this, and I don't know, it was starting to get cold. Yeah, temperatures dropped again, figures. So I don't know what I'm gonna do with that. Probably just use this for now, but we'll see. But yeah, it works good, and I'm pretty impressed with how high it goes. With the double pivot, one at the back and then this other one with the leaf spring, you get a lot of clearance, so that shouldn't be no issue of hanging up. And the mount is so low profile, you might even be able to leave that on in the summer, but it's only four bolts if you want to take it off anyways. But maybe we'll just show you how easy this is to put on and off here. Take it off. You just unhook the hook. Back over here is your pedal to remove it. Grab it by the nice handle in the blade. Just give it a push. Now off she comes. Now to hook it back up, you just hook on your hook, run your cable through the guide hook, lift it up a bit, come around the front. That's it, she's on. Click and go. Just drop her back down and take your winch line out of the guide hook. And that's it. And then just lift her up. You're good to go. The other nice feature I like, if you want to angle the blade, you just come up to the front, hang onto the blade, push down on the little pedal that lifts the latch out of there, adjust it to where you want to, and it'll lock in, whatever. You don't have to get down on the ground and climb around. So yeah, that's pretty cool. One other thing I wanted to point out, you also have this adjustment here that controls the aggressiveness of the blade. If you want it to lean ahead more or lean back more, just loosen that bolt and you can turn this in four different positions. So yeah, there's the back look of where it hooks onto the mount right there. No climbing around underneath it to hook it on like you saw, just push and click and go. So now I'd like to give you a demo of how it works, but as you can see, we don't have any fresh snow in the driveway, so that'll have to be on another video, but we'll be sure to show you. So that's gonna about wrap it up for the install of the Kimpex Click and Go 2 plow on the 2015 Can-Am Outlander 1000. And if you would like more information on this, you can go to the link below or kimpex.com, or they're available from your local Kimpex dealer. That's about gonna do it. We'll see you all next time.